Welcome back to Build Some and presentation 23 on the timber framing code. And this time we're going to look at the bottom plate for our project. So the rules for bottom plates, 6.2.2.1 and 6.2.2.2. And then we also have rule 6.3.3, and we're going to look at table 14 for this particular project. So 6.3.3 states that bottom plates in single or upper story construction shall be determined from span table 14 of the supplements. The size of the bottom plates in the lower story of a two-story construction shall be determined from table 45. Again, similar to our top plates, if wall studs are positioned at or within 1.5 times the depth of the bottom plate from the supporting floor joists, the bottom plates may be the same size as common studs for any stress grade, and if the walls are positioned directly above floor joists or are supported by blocking or on a concrete floor, bottom plates may be a minimum of 35 millimetres deep for any stress grade. So straight away, just reading that, I can say that my bottom plate will be 70 by 35. And that's just, we can use 70 by 35 because we're on a concrete slab, and that's what it states. But I'll show you the table anyway. The rule goes on to say that double or multiple bottom plates may be used provided the allowable roof load width is determined in accordance with the span tables for members indicated being made up of multiples. So there's a few different equations there. Also, where the bottom plate supports studs supporting concentrated loads, the plate shall be supported over a floor joist, solid blocking between the bottom plate and the bearer or concrete slab. Trenching or holes in the bottom plate shall not exceed the limitations given in clause 6.2.1.4. So here's our table. Again, we've got truss spacings, we've got sheet roof, so we can look at a sheet roof section. Our truss spacing 600, so we can go down that column. Our joist spacing 600, so we have to use 600 row. So the table says that we can use 35 by 70 anyway, so we're cool on that. But the other thing to look at is that down the bottom of the table in your notes, look here at note 2, where the bottom plate is continuously supported by a concrete slab or solid nogging, or where the wall studs are directly in line with the floor joist, the bottom plate may be a minimum of 35 mil deep. So there you go, 35 mil, 70 mil wide wall. So we've got to use 35 by 70 for our bottom plate.